you believe it's November? Welcome to Cyprus. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Hey guys, Ben CG here and welcome to Cyprus. This is Limassol in the south coast of Cyprus. This is mainly where we're going to be staying. I've got a week here and I'm staying at the Four Seasons Hotel. Not that famous Four Seasons, but this hotel has an agreement to maintain the same standard of luxury in order to be permitted to use the brand name. It is actually a five-star luxury hotel. Now, full disclosure, I can't afford this sort of luxury. So the reason I am here is not because of a sponsorship or anything like that. It's actually because of my beautiful mother who is here with me, and she won a free week at this hotel as an incentive for her work as a travel agent. I'm just kind of tagging along. All I had to pay for was my flight. Not complaining at all. I'm here in November, which is very much in the off season. So there's a lot of stuff that's closed. But the weather's still surprisingly quite nice. It's about 21 degrees Celsius, and most of the time it's been sunny. We've had some rain here and there. When we got here, it was actually pouring down, torrential rain and thunder. But generally, it's been quite good, the weather. It's just a challenge finding something to do in the evening. But we're going to go exploring Limassol, get out of this sort of depressing tourist strip with all the tacky restaurants and shops, and see what beautiful Cyprus has to offer. So come with me. So Cyprus is an island country in the Mediterranean, close to Turkey and also close to Syria and Lebanon and Israel, so quite far in the southeast, which is why it's so warm this time of year, just where in the world it is. Culturally, this is quite an interesting country because this island is split almost down the middle between Greek and Turkish peoples, and you do have to get your passport checked as you cross between them because there's a United Nations buffer zone in the middle of the island. So it is a bit of a unfortunate division that's been going on since the 70s, not too dissimilar perhaps from North and South Korea, except thankfully the Turkish northern side is not a horrible dictatorship. So we're going to go exploring mainly in Limassol, which is on the south coast, on the Greek side of the island, and hopefully have a lovely week in the sunshine. This is, after all, a very safe country, very economically stable, and because it's also been a British protectorate for a while, a lot of people here speak English, they use UK plugs, and they drive on the left-hand side of the road. It's all good. Well, this looks like it's going to be a laugh. The Limassol Duck Store. They've got all novelty rubber ducks. Wow. Even a pika duck. And of course, saving the best till last. So this is the old seaport and Limassol Marina. Lovely promenade along this way with restaurants and cafes by the water. Lovely area. So this is the municipal park of Limassol Marina. It's very nice, lined with palm trees. A bit of decking out to the water. Plenty of nice bars on the marina that you can sit and have a look in and enjoy a drink by the water. It's all very, very, very quiet now though, because it's November. April through to the end of October is probably the best time to come, but like most places in Southern Europe, try and avoid July and August because it's thronged with families and international tourists on their summer holidays. And probably it'd be too hot in Cyprus for July and August anyway, because the sun's really strong over here. I love this.
obviously the ground is painted to make the water look this kind of shade of blue, but it's really beautiful. Beautiful contrast with the decking and the green. Not entirely sure what these are supposed to be. I don't think Cyprus is quite the sort of country you'd go skiing in. So this long street right through the centre of Limassol is where all the shops are. It's called Anaxarchesias, or what was it you called it?
Anaphylactic Street.
Anaphylactic Street. Clearly not getting the hang of Greek very well. Got some of these honey-coated cashews and almonds with different flavours like pomegranate, Nutella and biscotto. They're really yummy. Tastes like candy corn. Go on, get in there, Mum. What do they taste like?
Yum.
Yum. Succinct review. I think that's the town hall there. Nice little city, Limassol. So this is the beautiful hotel of the Four Seasons. This is the lobby. It's all very glitzy glamour, five star. They're getting ready for Christmas with these snowflake-like things. So, little quick room tour. It's very nice. Lovely comfy beds. They're really high up. They're like hospital beds, but they're so cushy. Really comfortable. Nice telly. Got BBC One and ITV on there. We've got a tablet here that will control all the functions of the room. Curtains. Those. Ooh, look, all done through here. Very cool, nice ambient lighting as well. And then this is the bathroom, toilet behind a glass door, very swanky swanky, got some blinds that go through to the rest of the room, but they're shut for obvious reasons. Mwah, a shaving mirror. See what I'm filming this with? The shower's really cool. You can sit down in there. And this is my favourite part. We've got mood lighting. Look at that. And it changes colour. You can actually... It works like an old iPod. Just cycle your thumb around the spectrum.
Even though it is closed, it's probably going to be a bit too awkward, but this is the massage room. Look how beautiful.
Hey guys, hope you're enjoying the video so far. So today it is a little bit cloudy, as you can see behind me, but that means it is a good opportunity to get out of the hotel, out of the tourist strip, and see something a little bit of interest. So I have struggled to find points of interest in the area local to Limassol, I have to be honest. Cyprus does seem to be mainly a fun in the sun sort of destination. But today here we are at the Kurion archaeological site. These are kind of Greek Hellenistic ruins from the BC period up until about the 3rd century, so these are seriously old. There's a Greco sort of Roman amphitheatre, and there's ruins of an ancient city, so should be pretty cool, and there's some cool mosaics to see as well, get that ancient Greek aesthetic going in there, so should be fun. Let's go explore Kurion. So we're starting at the house of Epistolios, who is like the founder of the Kurion village. This part is all covered over to protect it from erosion and the elements, but you can see the ruins, the stones, of what it all used to be. This was like a jacuzzi. So they had cold water in here and they had hot water over there, and they would switch between the two, as we do in spas ourselves these days. And there's some cool mosaics over here. Look at these. This is the real thing. You only imagine. That can sing both high and low. Trip no further, pretty sweeting. Journeys end in lovers meeting. Every wise man's son doth know. Look at that, it's like a little hole just here. Looks like there's some shelter under there as well. I wonder what that would have been used for. A dungeon maybe? There's like a sort of windowed ceiling there. And the iron bars over there as well. Iron bars! All these little doorways, look. Can only imagine what it was all used for. They couldn't have all been dungeons. You know, this is a hot country normally, so could well have just been homes. This is the amphitheatre. This is so cool. I think this is still in use as well. Look, they've got the studio lights. So
nothing in there.
Not anymore. Quite a small dressing room. A bit claustrophobic. You can see the remnants of something a bit arty here. Gosh, you can only imagine, can't you? Ooh, windy. It's all pillars and everything here had a purpose of some kind. Built and destroyed by an earthquake. A terrible thing. Every square was a room. This was probably a courtyard, maybe, unless that tree was planted later. So apparently this was a basilica, an episcopal church, from the early Christian era. Beautiful views out to sea. Gorgeous. Do I have any Greek subscribers who know what this says? Magnificent view of the beach. There's some cafes and restaurants down here. It is a bit of a tourist attraction. Okay, one last quick stop of interest is Colossi Castle. So that's behind me, and it's about 10 minutes away from the Kurion archaeological site. And actually, if Google Maps is just to be believed, behind this castle is a marked border between land that technically belongs to Cyprus and land that technically belongs to the UK. So we have a RAF, Royal Air Force base there. Ooh, this is cool. It's all completely empty. Nice and cool in here. little windows out to the... What's down here? Goodness me, I have to crouch. Ooh, the ground floor is divided into three rooms roofed by pointed barrel vaults of equal dimensions, 12 by 5 metres long, 3.5 metres wide, that interconnect through arched doors. In two of the three rooms there are water systems, indicating that the ground floor was probably used as a storage area. Up to the top now. I love me a good spiral staircase. You do kind of have to put your hand on a step and work your way around. And here we are at the top, and I'm out of breath. Wasn't too long, but I'm not that fit, so yeah. Nice views. It's quite a dry country, Cyprus, but some bits of it are green. This is a nice view. See all the mountain villages in the distance. Provincial Cyprus. Beautiful. Wonder what's down this hole in the middle. Oh, crisp packets. Lovely. Nice one, human race. Okay, time to go back down. It's cool. Quick, but cool. Time to get some nice postcards. Oh, they've got good ones here. There's a wave. So we're in a taverna for dinner. It's our last night in Cyprus, and it's called Avenitu Vasileia. And it's decorated a bit like a traditional village, sort of in summer. It's really pretty. You've got all the things on the wall, you've got blue doors, a tree that's in the middle of the building for some reason, and sort of plants and trees this way and that. There's going to be some live music here later, so that'll be fun. We have come quite early, so there's no one here at the moment, but we're hoping it's going to fill up over the next hour or so. And we're going to have some lovely Greek food. Eat, drink, and be merry, because that's what Europe's all about. Here's the main course. That's pork. That's pancetta. What kind of meat is it? That's chicken, and that's lamb kofta, is it? Is that a kofta? Something like that. Greek salad here as well. Yummy, yummy, yummy.
A herby sausage.
So desserts here. So it's like a crumbly phyllo pastry on the bottom with custard in the middle, cream on top, and crushed pistachio nuts. And this is some kind of ice cream. So the flavour of the ice cream is called mastiha, and it comes from a plant that grows on the Greek islands. It smells like perfume. Yeah, it tastes very floral, refreshing. It's not quite vanilla, not quite milky. It tastes like flowers. It's really nice though. And combined with the pastry, it's really, really good. Cyprus, if land could dab. So that is going to bring me to the end of a mostly very relaxing week in Cyprus. I would recommend this as a place to come if you want some warm sunshine outside of the high season, because the weather is considerably warmer here than in the rest of Europe. Even here in mid-November, it's still
19 degrees Celsius, you know, look at me, t-shirt and jeans, it's lovely. But for culture vultures, the area local to Limassol doesn't really have too much to offer. If you go to the rest of the island, there's the ominous mountain villages, the resort of Paphos is also very touristy, and there's Aphrodite's birthplace near there, and you've also got the famous Napa beach. So there are still some other things to do here in Cyprus, but I haven't had time to cover them all, sadly. But if you did enjoy this video, please make sure to give it a like, comment and subscribe. Come and see me on Facebook at facebook.com/bencgvideos. You can also tweet me. My username is in the description. I want to thank all the staff at the Four Seasons Hotel for their amazing service and a great stay. And I will see you soon for more travel videos just like this one in the future. Ciao for now.
Kypros, ευχαριστώ πολύ.